Modest wear no longer sits on the fringe of the fashion world, but most big Western brands show a lack of understanding of the concept and the market. Fortunately, this gap in the market is being filled by high-end ranges created by talented designers. And here's a taste of the selection presented at a recently launched pop-up boutique in Cape Town.
With Muslims making up almost a quarter of the world's population, female members of the faith are estimated to spend over $40 billion per year on clothing, and the demand for modest fashion is increasing. This has had an impact on ready-to-wear and the upper end of the market, with Cape Town being no exception to the trend.
Modest wear has been taking over the runways globally, and it's evolved from a choice to a fashion statement. High-end modest wear is all the rage, and today we get a taste of the creme de la creme of what modest wear has to offer.
Modest wear designers have shown an ability to experiment, innovate, and think laterally, and marketers are following this lead. This type of trend-setting approach could be seen at the launch of a pop-up boutique recently, with a Seapoint Art Gallery as the venue. Fashion fundi Roshan Isaacs has spotted a niche in the local market and decided to fill it with flair.
Roshan, what made you believe in Haute Elan as a brand and decide to spearhead its move to South Africa?
Well, it's a discussion we've had with Haute Elan for quite a long time. We isolate ourselves to only our market, and I thought it was about time we brought an international presence to South Africa to start broadening the opportunities for our local designers.
Could you take me through some of the local designers showcased here today?
We have Zaman SA and Thabo Maketa. Those two specifically because they have a very different signature to their designs. I found those two very rich in diversity and culture and thought they would be perfect to fit into the Haute Elan for today.
Line, color, and texture are elements that play a role in fashion and art, and there's a natural synergy that results when a boutique and a gallery come together.
I think it's absolutely incredible. I think there's symbolicism between taking something that's just a plain piece of clothing that is modest wear and turning it into an artwork really aligns itself with our gallery. It's a really beautiful space to do something like this in, and we really love having Haute Elan with us.
The event also showed that South Africa is now recognized as a significant modest wear market.
What do you think of a brand like Haute Elan coming to South Africa?
Them recognizing South Africa as a market for them is amazing. I mean, not only for us, but for them as well.
There is sometimes a belief that modest wear can be limiting.
I don't really think so. You kind of just have to play around and make it work for you.
Roshan Isaacs introduced the CEO and founder of the brand, Romana Bins Abubakar.
Tell me a bit about your brand and where did it start and how has it evolved into what it is today?
Haute Elan was originally created to be almost an incubator to support startup emerging talent from around the world to be showcased. So young women particularly who were talented had an art, but they had no way to really reach the market. We wanted to provide them with a commercialization platform, and it emerged out of that to become the luxury destination for modest fashion globally.
What do you think has changed the mindset around modest fashion globally?
Women have become empowered once again. They no longer need to dress in a way that is, inverted commas, I'd say sexy or bare all to be attractive. And therefore, they want a wardrobe that allows them to be and remain covered, but still be able to present that personality.
Of course, accessories transform an outfit into a look, and fashionistas were dazzled by the choice on display.
We are so excited. I feel like it's been long overdue.
I think local designers are doing exceptionally well, and they're just like putting the wow factor, definitely.
I love the fact that everybody's being catered for. It's not just about catering for the Muslim modest woman. It's about women of all faiths and all cultures have something new to see to and look forward to.